Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about the pathophysiology of obesity and which are the treatment options available for obesity. Let's start with obesity. Now, what is obesity? It is medical condition in which there is excess body fat which is accumulated in various body parts, and ultimately it will reduce life expectancy, means it will reduce the number of life years. Now, what is the effect of obesity on health? It leads to various major diseases like heart disease, diabetes, sleep apnea, means lack of sleep, and it also causes certain types of cancer and osteoarthritis. Now, WHO has given classification of obesity, means you can calculate the BMI of your own and you can measure that in which class you are falling under. If it is less than 18.5, then it is underweight, and 18.5 to 24.9 is normal weight, means this is the normal BMI of adult human being, 18.5 to 24.9. And if it is above 40, then it is class 3 obesity, means obese person. And if it goes above 40, means 45 or 50, then it is super obesity. Now, what is the negative effect of obesity on health and life? Means how obesity will affect your body. It will reduce the life expectancy, it cause the bone problem, it cause thrombosis, joint problem, some type of cancer, and it also leads to breathing problems. Means sleep apnea. During the sleep, person feel a lack of breathing. Type 2 diabetes. It also increase sweating, high cholesterol level, and ultimately it cause some psychiatric disease like depression and social discrimination. Now, what is the pathophysiology behind development of obesity? There are some factors which leads to obesity. First one is diet, means excessive junk food, which will increase cause excessive food energy and lack of physical activity. Another one is sedentary lifestyle, means there is lack of physical exercise or lack of physical activity. Then there are some genes are also responsible for obesity. The gene called FTO gene, which is also responsible for obesity. Plus there are some medications are also which leads to obesity, like insulin, sulfonylureas, antipsychotics, some anticonvulsions, and some form of hormonal contraception. These all medications are also cause obesity. And some other disorders like hypothyroidism, in which there is a lack of metabolic rate, and hormonal deficiency cause obesity. Another one is hypothalamus damage. In hypothalamus there is hunger center which will regulate our appetite. This cause the destruction in this center or damage in this center will cause obesity. And there are some hormones which is also regulate the appetite, ultimately responsible for obesity. For example, leptin. If leptin will regulate the fat, and it also regulate the appetite, as it suppress the appetite as fat level increase, and when fat level is decreased, leptin level will fall and it will increase the appetite. Decrease in serotonin level is also associated with increased carbohydrate appetite. Increased neuropeptide Y also cause the increasing in appetite. Norepinephrine and dopamine is also responsible for thermoregulation, means it will also regulate the fat in our body. There are some complications associated with obesity, and ultimately these all complications cause type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular disease, shortness of breath, low back pain, and some sociological disorders like depression and low self-esteem. Now, how we can manage the obesity by pharmacological as well as non-pharmacological treatment. Now, let's start with non-pharmacological treatment, means reducing food intake, lower consumption of processed food and junk food will prevent the obesity. You can also block nutrient absorption by increasing thermogenesis, modulating fat metabolism. This all leads to prevention of obesity. Now, which are the medications available in market currently? First one is orlistate. Orlistate will act peripherally, which block the absorption of about 30% of consumed fat, means it will reduce the fat absorption. There are minor side effects related to orlistate. Another one is sibutramine. It will act centrally. It will act as a NRI, norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. It will inhibit reuptake of norepinephrine and serotonin also. So ultimately it will increase the norepinephrine and serotonin level. Another one is fenfluramine. It will act by centrally. It also stimulate release of norepinephrine. There are other agents which use sometimes for the treatment of obesity, but it is not approved by FDA. These are the ephedrine plus caffeine. It also acts centrally and stimulate adrenergic receptor. Another one is bupropion. This will inhibit reuptake of dopamine, norepinephrine and serotonin. It increase the dopamine, norepinephrine and serotonin. Another one is topiramate. Topiramate is also act centrally. It is anti-convulsion agent. And there are some newer anti-obesity agents which are under the investigation. It includes CNS agents that affect on ion channels. It includes antidepressant, serotonin 2C receptor agonist, some anti-convulsion agent and some histamine receptor antagonist. Drugs are bupropion and some anti-seizure compounds. Anti-seizure compound includes topiramate and zonisamide. Another one is noradrenaline reuptake inhibitors. These are the drugs which are under investigation. There are also cannabinoid receptor antagonists is also under the investigation. PPAR, alpha receptor antagonist, has also role in obesity. So these agents are also under investigation for obesity. Dopamine agonist and some other agents are also under investigation. These agents are under investigation. Thyroid hormone analogs are also responsible for obesity. There are some precautions that should be taken during taking anti-obesity drugs, like weight loss drug should never be used without continued concomitant lifestyle modification, means you cannot take only drugs. You have to do lifestyle modification. You have to increase your physical activity. The continual assessment of drug therapy and safety of drug is necessary. There are some contraindications of anti-obesity drugs are pregnancy, unstable cardiac disease, uncontrolled hypertension, unstable severe systemic illness, psychiatric disorder in which these drugs cannot be taken. And this is the algorithm for obesity development, how obesity will develop. Non-pharmacological treatment include lifestyle modification. So this is all about obesity and its treatment. Thank you.